In this video, we will talk about the Nernst equation and the Goldman equation. We will start with simple concepts and gradually dive deeper into complex things. So, let's get started with simple concepts. First, let's take a hypothetical cell that has only potassium channels on the membrane and no other channels. So, it is permeable to potassium only. And the electrical potential across the membrane is zero. Now, the concentration of potassium inside the cell is about 140 milliequivalent per liter. And that outside the cell is about 4 milliequivalent per liter. Thus, there is a concentration gradient favoring the exit of potassium. So potassium ions diffuse out of the cell. As they do so, they carry their positive charge with them. So now the outside of the cell becomes positive, and the inside of the cell becomes negative. This positivity outside the cell tends to repel the positively charged potassium back into the cell, and the negativity inside the cell tends to keep the potassium inside. This electrical gradient is called diffusion potential. As more and more potassium keep diffusing out, this potential gets stronger and stronger. Eventually, a point comes when this potential becomes strong enough to block the further exit of potassium despite the existing concentration gradient. Or in simple words, the diffusion potential balances the concentration gradient, so there is no net movement of potassium. For potassium, this happens at about 94 millivolts with negativity inside the cell. So this is the equilibrium potential if the cell is permeable to potassium only. Let's see one more hypothetical example with sodium. Assume that now the cell has only sodium channels and no other channels, so it's permeable to only sodium. And again, in the beginning, the electrical potential is zero. The concentration of sodium inside the cell is about 10 milliequivalent per liter, and that outside the cell is about 142 milliequivalent per liter. Due to the higher concentration outside, the sodium ions diffuse from outside to inside, and as they do so, they take in their positive charge with them. This makes the inside of the cell electropositive and outside electronegative. This potential opposes sodium entry into the cell, and with more and more diffusion of sodium, it becomes strong enough to stop the flow of sodium. For sodium, this happens at about 61 millivolts with positivity inside the cell. So this would be the equilibrium potential if the cell was permeable to sodium only. The exact value of this potential where the equilibrium is achieved depends on two factors, concentration gradient and electrical charge on the ion. The stronger the concentration gradient, the more the potential would be required to oppose the flow. And the more the charge on the ion, the stronger the potential develops by the same number of ions. For example, calcium ions have +2 charge, so it is 2 times more powerful in balancing the same concentration gradient. Thus, the equilibrium potential depends on the concentration gradient, which is basically the ratio of concentration inside the cell to that outside, and the electrical charge on the ion. The exact relationship between these factors is this mathematical equation. The equilibrium potential is equal to -61 divided by the electrical charge on the ion, multiplied by log concentration inside, by concentration outside. If you put the values of concentrations and electrical charge of any ion, you get the potential required to balance the movement of that ion. The guy who discovered all this was Walther Nernst, so this equation is called the Nernst equation. And the equilibrium potential is also called Nernst potential. Thus, Nernst made finding equilibrium potential for individual ions simple. But in real life, things are a bit more complex. First, in the body, multiple ions coexist together. So to find out the combined equilibrium potential, we need to take them all into account. The important among these are potassium, sodium, and chloride ions. And second, the permeability of the membrane varies for different ions. If a membrane is not permeable to a particular ion, that ion will not diffuse, and therefore it will not contribute to the development of potential. So when calculating the combined potential, we need to take into account the permeability also. The formula to calculate the exact potential was given by David E. Goldman, and it goes like this. It's like the Nernst equation, only but more complex. Here, C means concentration and P means permeability. This portion represents the contribution of sodium, this portion represents potassium, and this one is for chloride. Under resting conditions, the membrane is permeable to potassium, but its permeability to sodium is very less. So under resting conditions, the potential is largely determined by the diffusion potential of potassium. That is why the resting membrane potential in most cells is about minus 70 millivolts, which is close to minus 94 millivolts equilibrium potential of potassium. However, when the cell is stimulated, the sodium channels also open, and they also contribute to the potential, as the equilibrium potential for sodium is plus 61 millivolts. Overall, there is a shift toward a positive direction. And that's the reason why we see depolarization, inaction potential. So now you know the math behind depolarization also. So this was the Goldman equation. Now let's have a quick summary. If charged ions diffuse across the cell membrane, the resultant electrical potential opposes further diffusion of those ions. The exact potential where diffusion stops depends on the concentration gradient and charge on the ion. And it can be calculated by the Nernst equation. In real life, multiple ions contribute to the final equilibrium potential, depending on their permeability. In such a case, the potential can be calculated using the Goldman equation. That's it for this video. Click here to read the notes on this video at our website. You can also explore our entire physiology animation video library over there. To support my free content creation, first leave a nice comment and then share the video with all your friends and colleagues. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.